Hello students, welcome to the science class. Today we are going to start a new chapter, that is the chapter 4 of your science book, Matter and its States. Okay, so here you can see the three matters here. Now what are you going to learn from the chapter? You are going to learn about the matter and its properties, then the different states of matter, then changes in the states and the solubility. So these four things you are going to learn today. So let's proceed. Now you can see in the picture different types of substances all together. So all these things have different shape. If you can see, you can see a bottle of green shaped, then a yellow shaped, yellow colored something. Then different things are there in the diagram or in the picture, if you can see it nicely. Okay, so ultimately what we can tell is different things here are having different shape, different colors, even the different sizes, because the shape is different, accordingly the size is also different, but they have one thing common. Can you tell me what is the common thing here? Yes, this is all about a substance or a matter. So here we can see things around us are different to look and different to touch, but they all have one thing common. Here you can see two things they have hold, the boy has hold. They are by touching wise, they are different. If you touch them, they are different, but they have also one thing common in them. So So we have to find out what are the things which is the common in between them. So the different things here you can see, they have so the different things may have different shapes, different sizes, different textures, and may also behave differently, but they all common is that they all taking up some space and they have a weight. Whatever things you take, maybe you take a sandwich, maybe you take a banana, maybe you take something to play with, maybe you take anything, whatever you get, all the things I mean to say is whatever you things you touch, all are different, by shape wise different, structure wise different, even color wise different, but the common thing is that they take up the space and they have a weight. So from here we can say, we can conclude that anything that has weight and that occupies a space is known as the matter. Okay, so what is the matter? That is anything that has a weight, that occupies space, is the matter. Okay, so the things are basically, we can divide the things as living and non-living things. As you know that living and non-living things, for picture there are some things you can see as living, there are some things you can see as non-living. So living things are, say, plant, say, animal, human being, everything is living. On the other hand, the umbrella, the car, that means those who hasn't got the life, so they have non-living. But both of these things, there is one thing again common, that is they occupy the space and have weight. Some of these things that cannot be seen are also made up of matter. That means they have a weight, like they are occupy some space. These two things are common here. Okay. So here we will do some activity. So what are the things for the activity are required? 2 balloons and 3 weighing balance. So what is the activity? First, you know, we have to take balloons and fill them with air. You had seen here, we have taken 2 balloons and we had filled them through the air. Now, what we have, we put them in the weighing balance and check if it is balanced. Okay. Then we have to pick one of the balloons with a pin so that the air escapes from it. Okay. So after these procedure, like what we have done, first we have taken 2 balloons, then we had weighed it. After that, in one balloon we had pricked a needle, some air had come out. Then what we had seen, we see that the balance tilts to the side which has the balloon filled with air. That means 2 balloons are situated in the 2 sides of the balloon, so 2 sides of the balance. So one balloon we had made a hole and then some portion of the air came out. Then we are seeing that the portion, that means the balloon which is in that side of the balance, that means the balloon which contains air, which doesn't, air from the balloon didn't come out, so that side is tilted. So why this side has tilted? Because the weight of the air was present, weight of the air was maximum, due to which that side becomes heavier, so it had tilted. So from here we can see that air also occupies space and it has got a weight. Okay, now next we are coming into the properties of matter. Now what do you mean by property? That is some special characteristics. Okay, so these special characteristics are known as the properties of matter. That is, all the things are made up of matter and they have some properties. Okay, so first property, all matter is made up of tiny particles called the molecules, and these molecules are very small and cannot be seen through naked eye. Okay, so these molecules, all the matter, like the concept of the molecule, you will learn better when you will go into higher classes. But all the matter is made up of small molecules, and these molecules are so small that they cannot be seen in normal eye. We need special apparatus to see the molecules. Okay, so these are the matter is made up of molecules. Now the molecules of different things are different, and the responsible for how they look and feel. Here you can see that is all the molecules of different substances, different places, different matter, or the different substances, different things are different, and they are responsible for how they are look and how they feel. Okay, so how the matters look and how they look and feel, all are different. Okay, now there are some empty spaces in between the molecules. This space is known as intermolecular spaces. In the picture you had seen, there are some spaces in between the molecules, and these molecules in between the these spaces in between the molecules are known as the intermolecular spaces. Okay, now look at the different things in the kitchen. See, you can see the different things in the kitchen, all are present within the kitchen. Okay, so all of them have a different look. Okay, and also they have the pot, pan, they have, like, some are having the same shape, say for example pan and the pot, or say milk, juice, they are of same shape, and also they can be if say when milk or juice itself does not have any space, like does not have any shape. So what you do is when you are pouring them in the container, they are taking the shape of the container. On the other hand, the steam from the kettle, they are escaping and mixing into the air. So they have also neither any fixed shape. So we can say for example, pots and pans, do they change their shape according to the container or the state? What do you think? And the juice and the say milk, do they change their shape? And the steam, do they change their shape? You think about these answers. I am coming. So, according to this, actually there are three substances around them around us. The things around us are existing in the three states. Definitely they are different from each other. This is because of the arrangement of the molecules in between them. So the difference is the arrangement of the molecule in the different states of matter. You can see by the solid state, the liquid state and the gases. Like in the solid states, molecules are very much closely packed. In the liquid states, the molecules are not as closely packed as solid and not as loose as gas. And in gas, the intermolecular space is the maximum. Okay? So, this much only for today's class. That is in the next class, we will make you learn something more about the matter. Okay? That is something more about the solid, liquid and gases. Okay? So, till then, all of you stay safe. Take care. Thank you.